in business news.
The current cooperation between two countries I would describe very shortly. They are traditionally good, normal, positive. Our relations are workable, and what is the most important, they are very, very promising. Just a couple weeks ago, both countries, Ukraine and Cyprus, we marked the 25th anniversary of establishing bilateral relations between Cyprus and Ukraine. Having analyzed this quarter century period of time, we came to conclusion that our relations were permanently increasing and upgrading. To prove this statement, I just want to give some short figures. For what is the most important, Cyprus remains one of the biggest foreign investors of Ukraine. Cyprus invested to Ukraine sector economy about $12 billion. On the other hand, Ukraine remains one of the most important foreign investors of Cyprus, about $6 billion. For example, to prove that our relations are very good in all spheres, particularly in economic sector, last year total turnover of trade in goods and services reached about $0.5 billion. Taking into consideration the fact of limited measures of Cyprus market, such a figure, I think, is very demonstrating indicator that our relations in economic sphere, first of all, are really very good and keep huge reserves for their strengthening and upgrading. There are no limits for bettering any situation, as it is well known, but in our case, I think to improve and to encourage our bilateral relations in economic ties, I think it is high time to organize the next meeting of Ukrainian-Cyprus Intergovernmental Commission on Scientific, Economic, Technical and Industrial Cooperation. First meeting was held in Nicosia 4 years ago, and it has proved to be very helpful, despite that at that time we remember 2013, very difficult times, very difficult situation Cyprus was facing, particularly in terms of haircut process. But nevertheless, this Commission managed to work out a new mechanism to cope the situation. Now, when the situation visibly changed in better direction, now we observe that Cyprus is recovering in economic situation, is getting better and better. I think it's time to convene to organize the second meeting of such intergovernmental commission, to set new priorities, to think about how to arrange new breakthroughs. And I do know that there are many opportunities in tourism sector, in agricultural sector, and it's high time to start to work together in innovative technologies sector. So this meeting we expect to be held this year will be a good instrument to improve the situation and to open new horizons in our economic operation. All these components are very important for Ukrainian-Cyprus economic relations, but for the moment being, I think that tourism is the most attractive and promising sector of cooperation. Cyprus itself is a very attractive touristic destination, but taking into consideration such fact as the decision of Cyprus government to introduce free electronic visa regime, practically free visa regime, it encouraged a lot of Ukrainian tourists to visit Cyprus over the last years. So this is the good message for the rest EU countries, EU member states, to arrange the most favorable border cross regime for Ukraine, for Ukrainians, tourists, in order to strengthen our economic relations in this sphere, very important sphere as tourism is. After the revolution of dignity, which took place in Ukraine 3 years ago, Ukrainian authorities, president, the government, parliament, society itself, started implementing a strategic program of profound reforms. And now we are observing the positive results of this implementing of these reforms. Despite the current difficulties Ukraine is facing, you know, I mean the hybrid war that is being waged by Russia against my country, and practical military operations are being waged by separatists in eastern part of Ukraine, fully supported by Russia. These reforms now are bringing their positive results. The World Bank's doing business rating climbed Ukraine from 132 to 40th position. Such rapid shifting by 32 points is a very convincing proof that we are on the right road. Another example, our government has introduced innovative public procurement system. Internationally recognized, its name is Prozoro. In the English, it means transparency. This is another huge blow against corruption and to pave the way for recovery of our economy. So we see positive tendency in our economic development despite the war, despite the difficulties, despite the challenges and the threats from external factor. But this year we expect the GDP increasing in our country by 2%. That means that we are on the right way, and we expect good results in the future in our economic development. Answering this question, I want to put this question, such kind of question to you, I mean to Cypriots. How did you feel? What are your feelings now after the invasion of your so-called big neighbor 43 years ago, after illegal occupation, after deployment of a number foreign troops on your territory? The similar feelings we are experiencing now, the same tragedy, the same fundamental violations of fundamental human rights on the occupied territory. Crimea is an undeniable part of Ukraine, and making and organizing such so-called referendum 3 years ago, Russia violated numerous international treaties, and including Ukrainian-Russian treaty, towards which Russia took a commitment to be a guarantor of Ukrainian territorial integrity. So, feelings are not positive, but on the other hand, like Cypriots, Ukrainian nation, Ukrainian people, Ukrainian government, we are fully of optimism to restore the territorial integrity of our country, to restore the peace on our territory, and to start creating a normal, very prosperous society as we planned to build after the revolution of dignity. So I want just to stress, in knowing that Cyprus, better than any other nation in Europe, share the feelings of Ukrainians, knowing what does it mean, such aggression, such illegal invasion. We are grateful to Cyprus for territorial integrity of Ukraine, for support, for comprehensive support. So, due to this international cooperation and comprehensive international support, we are strongly confident that we will resolve this problem by peaceful means and accordance to European Union law.